With the Ottawa Senators over the last two seasons at least, and especially the last 2 years, a lot of negativity is derived from them. Even this year, so much bad stuff is happening. You got Bobby Ryan who's getting scratched and you're just wondering what he's going to do in his future. You had that incident with Scott Sabourin, which is just an abomination, or just sad across the entire league. It's just something you don't want to see, especially on such a team like that. You got Eric Brandstrom who's struggling, and I honestly feel they should put him in the AHL. I'm just saying, 2 points in 18 games, and he's not getting any ice time. It's just sad to see, especially from someone you think you should be making an impact already. Although, there's one shining piece. Actually, two. You can say Nilsson's doing pretty good for them. They have stepped it around over the past 2 weeks. I think they're like 8-10-1, which isn't last. It's good enough for not last. I don't know if they'll end up being competitive, but with this one line and for this one player they got going is Jean-Gabriel Pageau. The guy's on fire this year. He's really taken a step now that he's got all this ice time now. I'm pretty sure, if you're really talking statistically, he is a second-line center on this team, and along with his line mates of Connor Brown and Nick Paul, they have been arguably one of the better, more consistent lines in the league, and definitely the best line on this team. You know, if I can recall from the past, Pageau was always one of those guys you had to keep your eye on, but he wasn't anyone you had to be completely concerned about. I remember in the playoffs, he had that 4-goal game against the Rangers back when they had that run to the semis, and Pageau has always just been a little bit of an impact player. There are times, you know, he had to go through injury, especially last year, pretty much missed half the season, so it's tough to see. It was tough to see where his future would go, especially after that season, but he's already just come flying out of the gates. He's got himself a total of 11 goals and 4 assists for 15 points in the 19 games so far this year, and that's honestly awesome, especially with his linemates there. Connor Brown's got the 12 assists, and then Nick Paul doesn't produce as much, but he's got 8 points as well. But the big thing here, this is the big stat, and a lot of people, it's always a concerning stat. People never like to take it seriously. Some people think it's a bit of a crapshoot of a stat, and honestly it can be sometimes, but on a situation like this, when you're on arguably one of the worst teams in the league, but you have a plus 19, which is best for which is the league's best in plus minus by a landslide, I think he's over like John Carlson or something like that. Plus 19, Jean-Gabriel Pageau is a plus 19. I'm pretty sure I looked somewhere on the hockey news. Ken Holland had an article. He's only been on the ice against for, I think, 6 even strength goals and shorthanded goals. He's been on the ice against for 6 of them, really proving his ability to play as a two-way forward on almost that. If you can do that on the Ottawa Senators, I'm pretty sure you can do that on almost any team in the NHL, which kind of brings up a topic. Do the Ottawa Senators keep Jean-Gabriel Pageau, or do they let him go? He is a free agent next year. He is from Ottawa, so that's the one good thing they got going for him, but do you really want to stay there? Does he want to stay by and help the rebuild, but have to deal with the corrupt ownership and all that jazz? Or is he going to go to free agency and just find a team that better suits him? You can also argue that the Senators may want to trade him too before the deadline. Get something around, you know, I think definitely he's worth a first round pick, especially for a team that's going to be going deep into the playoffs. And it is such a deep draft, and they got so many first round picks already this season. They also got the San Jose Sharks. They can really expand their prospects core that they already got if they get rid of him. And with the way he's been playing lately, he should be easily drawing interest from other top caliber teams, looking for, like, you know, a third line center who can also score but also play that strict defensive game. I just say the main goal for Senators with Pageau is to just don't let him fall into free agency. You're either going to want to trade him for a draft pick or some other prospects, or you're really going to want to re-sign him, because I think he's only 27. He's got a couple more years that are good of him. I don't see him being someone, you know, who's 34 and he's still doing what he's doing now, but for the next like 5 to 6 years, he could definitely still be an impact player, and he could really help nurture a bunch of these young kids who are going to be coming to the program and teach them this awesome style of playing hockey where you can still score but still be a great 200-foot player. But with the two picks they already got this season that most likely could end up being top 10s, I really would keep Pageau. Hold on to him until the end of the season, and if he doesn't keep the production up and the style he's maintaining right now till the end of the season, then you can maybe let him go and find someone else to fill that void. But if he continues to play how he is right now, sign him to like a 4-year deal worth like $4.5 million, and just have him nurture all these guys that are coming up, because those two top 10 picks that they're probably going to secure in July next year, I mean, my dream is to see them draft the sweetest connection with Alexander Holtz and Lucas Raymond, but I don't know if that can happen. And I don't think Pageau's a guy who wants to leave. He looks like he's having an absolute blast out there. Every goal he scores, he's celebrating like an absolute fan. Like, you know he's a fan of Ottawa. You know he loves playing there already, even under the circumstances they are in. It just warms my heart seeing players play such a proper, such a mature style and get rewarded for it. And speaking of being rewarded, this may be a bit of a stretch, and I don't know what the whole deal is with the Ottawa Senators fans. If you guys are watching this, let me know what you guys would think about this. But he's been a guy who's been in this program now for such a long time. He's already got the assistant captain, and if he re-signs and stays with this team, is captaincy really an option for him? That's just something that's been flowing around my mind when I'm making this video here. I know he's been a fan favorite in the city since his four-goal night, and there have been ups and downs in his careers. But it's definitely sure that this guy definitely has the heart and soul to play here. And if he continues on next season, I think captaincy should really be an option. I just really wanted to discuss about this today, guys, because I don't know how relevant the Ottawa Senators are in the media right now, as long as it's like, you know, their success isn't really talked about too much. And I haven't seen too much of it on TV or anything or radio. But I really just felt this is something that needs to have a light shined upon it, because he's definitely off to a miraculous start. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.